Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. Now as you can see I reloaded the game so that we are back at the start of the tower. And this time I will show you a slightly different way to get where we want to go without having to go through about a million rooms and lose all our food in the process. First thing you want to do is get to the highest point you can without doing anything special, which means going to the left and then straight up for a couple of rooms until we hit a wall and can't go further up. This is actually the top of the tower, and similar to the overworld map, towers actually wrap around, which means that if you if there were a door up here, then and this is the highest level in the tower, then going through that door would put me in the lowest level of the tower, and the other way around. Same goes for left and right, of course. If you walk off the left side, you end up on the right side, and vice versa. So we're now all the way at the top of the tower. And one of the things we need to know is that all towers are effectively four squares wide. So there's room for four squares next to each other before you have to move into the next level. That's just the internal game mechanics. So if you remember from the end of the last video, we had on the far right, we had the fire drakes, then the room next to that was the nine keys, and the room next to that was all the random items, and then the room next to that was the boss. So the boss is on the far left and the fire drakes were on the far right at the bottom of the tower. Since we're all the way at the top here, and this is the top left room of the tower, there's no way, no place more left or more up than this one. If we were to go up from this room, let's say there were a door up here, that would mean we would end up in the bottom left room in the tower, which is the boss room, as I just talked about. Now we don't want to end up straight in the boss room, we want to get some of that nice loot that the fire drakes were protecting, so instead I'm going to move left 1, 2, 3 rooms. And here I am going to use a special item to be able to travel through this wall even though there isn't a door, which if you remember is the mantle. So using a single mantle will allow us to pass through this wall and get straight to the bottom of the tower without having to go through, like I said, all the annoying hoops you normally have to jump through. Not only does this save us a lot of time and food, it also instantly gets us our +4 small shield. And let's just get the drop on these dragons, or drakes I should say. And we even pick up a +2 battle axe, which is, oh that's right, that's actually stronger than our current weapon, so let's equip that right away. It's only one step up, so I'm actually debating a little bit whether it might be better to just keep our halberd until we get something better. As you know, our attack strength is going to drop initially because our experience with the battle axe is so low. See, our strength now is 20,000, whereas with the halberd it was 63,000. So you know what, I think I might just sell the battle axe. So yeah, the ending is pretty much the same as last time. We want to pick up all the keys, pick up all the random loot from this room. And then we want to go and kill the boss. If you remember, there's actually another halberd and another, I think, a small shield up there which we want to loot too, but we'll get to that after we kill the boss. I do want to immediately equip my shield because going from +3 to +4 large shield is much better. Defense is now 13,000, which was also about 14,000 with our previous one, but this one is going to get a lot better a lot quicker because it's two steps up from the previous one instead of just one. Now let's see, the boss is actually in the next room. The end boss for level 7 is pretty powerful, a lot powerful than the Grells we were facing before. So instead of risking my life attacking him with my halberd, I am just going to equip my deck scroll and hopefully be able to take him out before he gets to us. There we go. Clearly a scary guy. Four swords, four arms. Oh my. He's immune to corrosion, I forgot about that. Or actually, I didn't forget, I didn't know. So that's not gonna work. Now the good thing about boss fights is that you cannot use your elixir in them, so that means you will simply die instantly. And it saves the game right before you enter the boss room, so you will be able to retry immediately without going through too much effort. Clearly 45,000 hit points was nothing to this guy. He just beat us down in a single hit. So instead of our corrosion, let's take our tilt instead. I'm pretty sure it's not invulnerable to both of them. We just have to get a little bit closer to do enough damage to him. But that's okay, it's not too difficult. Let's get close and then just spam him with our magic attack as quickly as we can. And just don't let him get close enough to hit you. There we go, pretty easy. I think in general boss fights in this game are easier than the normal fights, mostly. And as you can see, this is very, very nice. We have hammers, bibles, silver pendants, boots, and a bible. So plus 10 to all the stats that have items to increase them. Plus 10 dexterity, an hourglass, plus 10 wisdom, demon ring, plus 10 strength, another hourglass, and plus 10 intelligence, and another demon ring. And finally, the crown for this level, which is really what we were after. The crown, if you remember, is the item that will give us access to the final boss in the last level. We have three of them now, so we only need one more in the upcoming levels. One more thing I wanted to pick up here are these guys. We won't be using either of them, but they will give us a pretty good price in the NPC markets. Now I'll go back to the dragon room and use another mantle to get back to the exit, because again I don't want to waste 20 minutes and a lot of food and health getting back to the exit. No health, but food at least. So here we will use the wraparound feature and get back up to the top of the tower. And then we'll head straight for the exit. Wow, my items are really lasting a long time now, thanks to that higher wisdom. So it's not just for the red potions that you want to upgrade your wisdom. As you can see, clearly, it's very convenient to be able to walk through walls for this long. And that's it for the tower for level 7. So, it's a big tower, it's an annoying tower, but it's actually, once you know the trick, it's really easy to clear. What else? You know what, I think this is pretty close to it for level 7. I think I want to kill a couple of more of these guys that are just running around outside. For the experience and for their golden items. Mostly the boobries for their winged boots. But also these drakes for a few extra onyxes, and just like I said, mostly for the experience, to be honest, at this point. We've got most everything we really, really need. So what I'm really doing is building up more levels now, so that we don't get instantly killed when we get to the higher levels. So yeah, like I said, I'll just be running around a bit, killing a couple more monsters, and then we will be heading up to level 8. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope this was interesting, and I will see you in the next part.